Hey, how you doing? Frank Lloyd Wright is hands down the greatest American architect. And today, you and me, we're going to build one of his modern cabins. Hiya, folks. So let's go ahead and get started on the tutorial, shall we? So let's do that by looking at our GPS coordinates here. We're at 43.3 latitude, 62.9 longitude here on the center map. And it's this nice little cliffside that gives you a good view of a lot of old ruins. There's one right there, and then some way over there in the distance right there. And I think that's just kind of the perfect place to build this cabin. Of course, you can build it wherever you want. By the way, let's take a look at the equipment list here. You can see that the number of materials is roughly double what you would need for this size of a cabin. That's because we are using double-sided walls here. That's kind of the conceit of this cabin build. So let's go ahead and take a look at the floor plan. And then as we get building, you'll kind of see what I mean. Here we go. We've got on the left side a 3x4 platform, and then on the right side a 3x5 platform. And this is to kind of mimic the style of Frank Lloyd Wright. Where he did this kind of cabin. It's called the Seth Peterson Cabin. You can see it in some YouTube videos. And we're kind of going after that sort of thing. And the way we're going to do it, so we're going to start with a line of wood platforms, wood foundations, right along this side here. And this is going to give us a way to do some double-sided fence foundations. So we're going to go up here so that it's in an L shape, which looks pretty good. And then what we need to do to kind of prepare the rest of this is go ahead and screenshot this. Screenshot how far you've gone so far so you don't kind of forget what the layout of the floor plan is, because it'll be really easy to kind of mess up some walls here. We're going to place some two stone foundations right here and right here. And let's get rid of the dodo in disguise, they don't make noise. Let's place three foundations. I want stone, actually. It's a little easier. Along this side, and then foundations right along that side. And this will let us kind of put some double-sided walls in as well. And so now that we have our thatch kind of thing surrounded, let's go ahead and fill in the interior with lots of stone. Okay, so here is our finished stone foundation with a little bit of wood here. We'll come to the wood in just a second. Right now, I want to talk about adding some support pillars. So that's our next step. But we have a little bit of a problem because all the places I want to put support pillars, I can't, which is kind of in these corners where these foundations intersect. Doesn't like me doing that for some reason. Don't know why. Just kind of a thing. So what we're going to do instead is... let's see. Yes. So you see here, we have three different snap points here. 1, 2, and 3. I want my snap point to be right in the middle here. And then what we need to do is we need to build, put a stone pillar there and a stone pillar there. And let's go ahead and build up. Let's build these up. Oops. 3 high. There we go. Very nice. And so now we have two stone pillars here. And then we need to put stone pillar right here as well on this side. So let's look. So 1, 2, and 3. So right in the middle there. And so we're going to put a stone pillar right there. And let's go ahead and build that up 3 as well. Those might need to go up 4, but if we need to add them, we'll add them at a later step. Okay. So now... we also need a final stone pillar right alongside here. So let's just kind of make sure it connects to the right snap point. If we connect it to the wrong snap point, it will create issues for our build later on. So it does need to be in the middle one. All right, let's put one right there, get some more pillars, and build this one up. Okay, and so you kind of get the idea. So let me go ahead and add pillars to the other 3 spots. Folks, I am interrupting my own tutorial here for a second for a special service announcement. This is the definitive placement of the pillars. And trust me, you want to get this right, okay? So this is the original floor layout, pretty much. And you have to get these right, because if you don't place them before you build the walls, you're going to have to tear the walls down. And that can cost a lot in issues, in resources, in time, and just all sorts of things. So you need to make sure you have all these pillars placed correctly, okay? So this one especially gave me problems, because when I was doing the teardown on another kind of project, I accidentally deleted this area and forgot to mark the placement of this pillar. And so it has caused me problems throughout the whole recording of this tutorial. So you're going to see this in this place for a lot of this next bit, at least until we get to, you know, this part of the tutorial. So just forgive me that stuff, and continue to build as we go through this video, okay? Okay, so I've added two pillars on these two spots right here, and I used fence foundations kind of oriented this way, because both of these we're going to cover up with walls, so you won't really see them. There's a third one here that deserves a bit of a special case, and this is getting into the next step. And so let's go ahead and start right here with the next step. So you see these two fence foundation snap points here. The wood foundations only let you do this. It's not possible on the thatch or the stone for some reason. So what we're going to do is we're going to put, this time, two fence foundations side by side. Okay, and then let's go ahead and let's snap pillars to it. And this one is going to go up only two as well instead of three. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's do this as well for this side and this side. And let's go all the way down. So let's start right here. And one snap point there, one snap point there. Oh, wait, what happened? Okay, it does weird things from time to time. So you just have to kind of stick with it. It'll kind of place things two by two. Sometimes it'll place them right on top of each other without destroying. It's kind of weird that way. If that happens to you, just destroy one of them and you should be good. And by the way, if you're getting a lot out of this tutorial, I would sure appreciate it if you share it around. That way more people will see it and I'll be able to make more of these for you, which I would love to do. So the more people see it, the more I can do. That's kind of how it works. And the reason it works this way is because YouTube really values people who watch videos on their platform. And I'm not gonna hide my motivations here, folks. I really want YouTube to grow, to become my full-time income, not for popularity or money, but just so that I am comfortable enough to where I can do this full-time, make valuable content for you that you want to watch, that inspires you to be creative. And that's really my whole MO here with these things. All right, so let's continue. So now we have a double-sided fence foundation on all sides of this, almost. We are leaving this one narrow side open because this is going to be the entrance to our house. So before we get to the entrance, we need a door frame and windows. So before we build the door frame and get all that, let's work on the windows. All right, so we got a greenhouse glass wall right here. And you see how it's kind of snapping right in between them? We want that. Now, I think there's only one snap point here for the glass wall. Yeah, because it's not going to snap to the fence foundations, which is great. So we're going to just do that. And you want to do that almost all the way down. Let's go here, here. Oh, wait, before we do this, we want to go down basically to right here so that it's four wide. But before you do all this, you're going to have a hard time with this sheer cliff placing these outside railings if we don't do these one at a time. So here's how I would recommend doing it. Place a railing right there, and come on. Why is this not working now? There it is. And a railing right there. And they'll occlude through the glass wall, and we'll make a nice little decorative kind of stone wall thing. And then place them, just do it one at a time for those four, and I'll see you on the other side of that. Now that we have that done, what we need to do is do railings on this side, double-sided again, and there we go. and railings over here on this side. Again, double-sided. You just go all the way down here and around. So the beautiful thing about this is that because we kind of had to design this so that we had a nice little ornamental half wall here before we got to the windows, we get to extend that all the way down here and all the way out here. And the same design just kind of turns into a railing. So it's a very elegant kind of solution. I like it a lot. Let's go ahead and continue by building this up. But first we need to do some door frames so that we know where the inside from the outside is. So let's put a door frame right there. And let's put a door frame right there. And why don't you go ahead and put a door frame right here too? It doesn't matter the snap point too much. Just make it pretty and we'll all be happy here. Okay, so now we've got that done. Let's go ahead. Let's extend this up 3 high, okay? But let's do something to kind of make it so that it doesn't look all grid-like. So let's put some door frames up here. And that'll kind of make things nice and tidy here. Let's put a door frame right there. Oh, I'm sorry. That's a wall right there. And then we'll do walls all the way across here like so. And then we can put in some doors like right there and right there and right here and right here. And then we'll need some sloped greenhouse wall lefts. And they'll work on both sides. If you have sloped greenhouse wall rights, those will actually work too, I believe. I don't think that looks... Well, hang on, let me check. Does that look a little off to you? No, that works. That works. That lines up pretty well if we're being serious here. So once we have that, let's go ahead and walk, and then let's put standard greenhouse wall right there as well. So that's pretty cool. We have kind of the front-facing part that's really pretty, especially in the mornings. Let's do set time of day 9. Oh, admin sheet. Let's admin sheet so I can show you this. There we go. That's what it looks like at 9 a.m. You can kind of see it's a really beautiful sight to wake up to. The sunlight streaming through your windows. It's a wonderful sort of look. Let's go ahead and let's finish it up really quick. Let's go ahead and change out these wood foundations to stone because our job is now done. They have allowed us to place these double railings, and those railings will now stay once we replace this with stone. It's very nice and economical. Well, not really that economical, but convenient. That's the word I was looking for. Let's go ahead and finish this off, and then we can go ahead and start working on placing our external walls. Doing these external walls is not that tricky, but you do need to make sure that you have things kind of configured right as far as the snap points go. So if you notice, we've got two kind of snap points here, one and two. Each one is going to snap opposite of what you would rather have. So if we want to snap to this wall here, we want this one facing this way. And on the interior snap point, you want it over here, and you can press Y again. And it should just snap like that. And we want that to go around to this as well. So let's go ahead, place one right there. And let's place one. Oops. Yeah, that's going to do that with the fence foundation in the way, unfortunately. But it should be okay. Okay, so that's... The fence foundation is doing something funky here. See if we can fix it. Yeah, there we go. Awesome. So you'll see that the fence foundation does kind of stick through a little bit. We might be able to hide that with some paint. We'll see what happens. Hopefully I remember to bring that back up. But anyways, this wall right here, we want to go up 2 high on both sides. And I'm putting it stone on both sides because that's the way the Scott Peterson cabin looks. And then we want stone on this side, too. So there's our interior one. And there's our, exterior one. Let's do that again for this one. And then rotate there. Okay, awesome. And so now we just need one more for there. and one more for here. And now that all this stuff is up, when we remove these two foundations, everything stays. It's very nice. It's actually very nice. All right, so I have gone ahead and I have added the stone walls that we will need for the exterior for now into this build. So you can kind of see. Now, I didn't go all the way up here because we're going to need to place a ceiling before we can go all the way up to the top for this section. And I realized we have a bit of an issue. This pillar here, I apologize. I told you to place it. It needs to go away. It does not belong here. Shun it. It is an unbeliever. Let's go ahead and do window frames right here. Now, the reason I'm doing window frames this high is to kind of create an enclosed feeling of safety. This was one of Frank Lloyd Wright's design philosophies behind making the original Seth Peterson house. So, let's go ahead and go outside and let's add the exterior window frames too. And so we kind of want to do the same thing, same sort of philosophy. The whole thing is, if you go out here, it's going to be wide open spaces, very adventurous looking. It's freeing to see, to be in such a, you know, a tall place. But as we go in here, it kind of encloses down because these are where the living quarters are going to be, where you're going to sleep, shower. And so everything's really kind of enclosed. It's in stone. And that's because it's there to make you feel comfortable and safe. And to be honest, kind of sleepy, you know, so you can actually sleep. And there's a thunderstorm and those thunder clouds get in the way. So let me go ahead and speed past those really quick. Okay, there we go. All fixed. I just really hate thunderstorms because they're loud. They get in the way. They drown out the sound. And this is supposed to be a tutorial. Dang it. All right, so once we have these walls placed here, we can also get rid of these foundations because we don't need them anymore. Our double-sided foundations are placed. So let's go ahead and get rid of them up to this point. And then we need to place stone doorways here because we're going to make a nice little kind of accent window. Yeah, I think that's right. And yeah, let's just go too high for now. It will go three high, but right now we're just going too high. And then we can add in doors. And I want the exterior door frame snap point, not the interior one. It just looks better that way. Okay, very nice. All right, so that should allow us to place ceilings unimpeded. But before we can do the ceilings, we need to do the interior walls. So let's start on the interior walls, shall we? So we're going to put a door frame right here. And we're going to go ahead and do it double-sided as well. Not that way. Now, this is a little bit tricky because we're going to have to start varying our material types. So here, it's still stone, if I can do it correctly. Good grief. There we go. And then here on this side, we're going to want regular wall. So let's go and put regular wall right there. Okay. And let's go two up. Let's go ahead and place these so we don't get confused. So let's go ahead. Let's do that. And let's do, my mouse goes into the corner and triggers my team viewer every once in a while. It's a little annoying. Okay. There we go. So now that we have that, we're going to leave this alone because we're going to put wood walls in there, but I want to build the stone ones out first. So this is going to be a solid wall. And this is going to be a solid wall. There we go. And by the way, there's one more thing I'd like to tell you about. It's my Discord server. If you're interested in joining a like-minded community of ARK builders, go ahead and join. The URL is down in the description below. It's also right here on screen, but it's a lot of little letters and numbers, so it might be easier just to click the link in the description. If you want to show off your ARK builds, talk to me personally, or get some building advice, go ahead and join. I'd love to have you. Great. Now, this one right here is going to be solid. We can still walk through. Very good. And this one right here is going to be solid. Okay, very nice. So this makes a nice little enclosed bedroom. This is going to be, you can turn it into a storage closet if you want, or you could just leave it empty. That's what I'm going to do. It's going to be my bathroom, and we're just going to keep the door closed. Oh, speaking of which, that needs to go be a stone wall too. I will go back through and make sure I have text annotations. You know that. Okay. Last little bit of stone masonry left to do is this bit right here. And we're going to place a fireplace here. But first, we need to put a door frame right there. And very interesting. So I think we need to put the door frame. It's always a little tricky. So you're going to have to try this a couple times. I don't think you want the most exterior snap point. You want the one that's kind of almost on top of the door frame. I think or the fence foundation. I think the fence foundation, it might create an additional snap point. I'm not quite sure. But we have the door frame there because when we place the fireplace later on, this little gap here is going to let the kind of the fire bit of the fireplace kind of show through. And it'll be very nice. Trust me. All right. So now we do... Now we do a little bit of stone wall right there. And now we come to the kitchen. So the kitchen, we're going to use wood walls. I said wood walls. And we're going to stand all the way over, press E. Yeah, and it's going to place like that. And so we're going to coat both sides, both levels of this with wood all the way around. And then we'll paint this a nice sort of cantaloupe color later on so it doesn't look so janky. Because I don't like this this color or this texture unless it's on the exterior of a log cabin. You know what I mean? So let's take a look at what we've got done so far. Whoop, there we go. A little bit of lag here, but that's all right. Okay, so if you did everything right, the pillars should be in these spots. You should have walls built up too high, and they should all be double-sided. It should look very pretty, very elegant, very kind of neat. Somehow I think this might be the way ARK designers really kind of intended the building system to work, knowing how crazy all the snap points are. Well, I think we've finally cracked the code, folks. So, next bit is we need to build in, let's see, ceilings. Where's my ceilings? So let's put my ceilings in my number two spot, since that's where, actually, that's not where they're supposed to be. Those are supposed to be there. Those are supposed to be there. It actually helps for the hotkeys. So let's place one right here. And I want it facing kind of, I want the wood grain going this way towards the glass. And that's because I like the way the underside goes the other direction back and forth when you're on the inside. So you just place it almost square on that pillar. And then we need to bring it across. And when you do bring it across, make sure it's on the right orientation because it does get a little screwy here. I can't get rid of this. I don't know why. All right, there we go. So just be careful as you place these. You're going to get a bunch of different orientation snap points. So just kind of be careful and you'll get it figured out. Okay. And so we go up here, just fill it in like so. And then I think we can go through these pillars. If not, we'll have to delete them. No, we can go through them. Good. We wanted to go right up to this point for that. And then, right there. And then right there. Right here. Right here. And another tricky spot is this pillar right there. And you can press Q to kind of cycle through your snap points. It makes it a little easier. And then we need to go a couple more ceilings. Almost there. One right there. One right there. One right there. There. And there. And that should do it, I believe, for the ceilings as far as they go. For this bit. Now, the next bit, we need to actually kind of base the ceilings right here. And we're going to kind of offset these a bit. And as you do this, make sure that these are still aligned the same way. They line up almost perfectly, so you really won't notice the double kind of the double joists right there. I think it'll be fine. And we just kind of go all the way across so that this lines up very nicely like that. And that's going to overlap just a little bit, but that's okay. It's not that big of a deal. You will see kind of a little bit of an issue with kind of gaps here. If it really bugs you, because we do have overlaps, you can go ahead and snap the wood walls to the exterior, like so. And it should be fine. It should cover over just fine. Don't worry about this. Actually, you probably don't even need to worry too much about this either, because we will be covering this up with a third floor. Speaking of a third floor, it's time to kind of get started on that, sort of. What we're going to do is we're going to put sloped wood walls right here and right here. Come on, right there. Right there. And one more right there. There we go. Right on the tick. Now, if only the Postal Service were as efficient as the Weather Service. Okay, so let's continue. Let's go ahead and let's build up on our third floor, okay? So I know I'm flying around. You should be able to do this pretty easily with ladders. All right, so you can put a door frame right there. Then we're going to put a wooden wall right there. Very nice. And you don't need to double pane these. So all you need to do is just make sure that they kind of line up. So this one doesn't really line up that much. It might be an issue. Let me see if I can fix my finger cannon, because that is annoying. Yes, there we go. Okay, there we go. And then if we do this. Yes, very nice. So yeah, just kind of build these along. Build the ceilings along as you go. You should be able to kind of slot in the walls, and they should just snap pretty nicely. Yeah, very good. Let's go ahead and continue on. And let's go three out here. And, oops, three out. Like so, almost. Yeah, this one's a little trickier, this side, apparently. So let's bring out the ceilings just to kind of help with the placement. Yeah, see, that just helps out a whole lot if you build the ceilings out first. I don't know why, they kind of take snapping priority, almost, except for right there. I don't know why I didn't do it right there. Okay, very nice. So two more ceilings. Oops. Okay, so we have different snap points here. a lot different snap points, actually. It's because of this one being a bit of a pain. And there we go. All right, so that's good enough for government work, I have to say. If you really want to be a stickler, you can make it line up. I don't really care that much. But that is pretty much the exterior, all said and done. Let's put a door in here. Yeah, there we go. So if you look at it, you can kind of see, oh, hey, yeah, it kind of works out pretty well there. Kind of looks good. If you want this area here to be three high, go ahead and put in stone door frame right here and then get rid of this. Oops. And this bit. And you'll have to leave this open, but that's okay. It's not that big of a deal. You'll just have to have this shelf here. But yeah, for the most part, if I can get this to snap correctly. Good Lord. Oh, it's difficult. Oh, yeah, it's getting crazy here. Once we get it figured out, it should snap just nicely. Yeah. Okay, there we go. Good enough. I don't really care too much. If you want to replace this and really try to make it work, you totally can. I'm not going to spend camera time on it, though. Okay, so there. We now have our interior almost done. Let's go ahead and add these windows. Let's put them on the exterior again, the exterior window frame. So just press Q key to do that if you are placing them from inside. But we are just about ready for the furniture. Let's go ahead and place doors. I'm going to put a door. It doesn't really matter if you want it on the interior or the exterior. I'm going to put this one on the interior just because I don't plan on using this room. So, oop, there you go. And this one goes on the exterior because I plan on spending more time out here than I do in there. Very nice. All right. And then we can put greenhouse doors right here. So here's something interesting we can do with these greenhouse doors is we can actually double pane them if we want. So let me see if I can. Yes, there we go. We've got some greenhouse doors. So, oops. If I double pane them, you probably have to do one from the outside. Yeah, there we go. Actually, you do them both from the outside. And what this is going to let you do is, this is a great trick. I learned it from UTC. You can put an interior door so it's pointing that way, and then put an exterior door. Actually, strike that, reverse it. Now you put an interior door on this side so it's pointing this way. You put an exterior door on this side so it's pointing that way. Back here, you can't tell that they're slightly off. Before we get to the painting, we need to place a couple extra things. Let's go ahead and place our fireplace. So you just kind of center it up here, and then you bring it slowly towards you until it turns green. And then you kind of even yourself in so that you don't place it crooked. You can tell by how much it occludes into the stone doorway behind you. Place it. There you go. Looks pretty good. And then if you go outside and we fly up a bit or you walk far enough back, you'll be able to see it sticking through the roof. Very nice. Okay. Next thing we need to do is we need to get some foundations here. We're going to place another foundation right here, and then we're going to use a little pillar foundation lowering trick. All right. So we're going to place a foundation here. And then we're going to place a foundation. Let's see. Can I do it? Nope. Has to be right there. Right there. And you see how the left foundation is just slightly lower than the right foundation? Let's do that a couple times. Just go back and forth, like so, until you end up with a foundation. It's about halfway through. You can delete this. And then we place this in. Yes. You see? We have two foundations that we can just place right there, and it makes a nice front porch. It's pretty cool. I love that little trick. It's just so fun. And I'm very happy with it. Okay, so one thing you could do, a little bit of a vanity thing, is if you don't like these pillars just kind of sticking out where they are, you can put a pillar on the end, like right there. The only thing is it sticks up a bit, so I'm not doing it on my version. I'd like to have it much lower, but the pillar lowering trick doesn't work with snapped pillars. It only works with the freestanding or the ones that are kind of snapped a little bit off of another object. Your mileage may vary on that, but it is what it is. Okay, so let's start kind of painting this. Let's take a look at the wood walls first. Get this kind of a nice cantaloupe color. And what we want to do for these is we don't need to pay attention to the interiors of these walls. We just need to pay attention to the exterior. So we've got cantaloupe on it. And the exterior is color region 6, okay? So if we dye that, and then we go ahead and we add cantaloupe to our paint. All right, and then we select it. If you right-click, press 1 to disable region 1, press 6 to enable region 6. Now you can just kind of spray anywhere you want here. And these six things will line up very nicely. But for the ceiling, we need to do the opposite. So let's go ahead and take a look at the ceiling here. And let's see. The color region 5 we do not want. We don't want color region 6 because that's the top. So we just want color region 1, basically. Actually, strike that. We want 1 and 6 because the top is going to be cantaloupe as well. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's dye all these cantaloupe. All right, so now we've got the interiors all cantaloupe. And the exteriors, all cantaloupe. Now for these, on these sloped ones, you want to enable region, 2? Region 2 as well. And that way, it just kind of blends in with the rest of the ceiling. We don't need no stinking other things messing it up. Okay, now this little bit is kind of interesting. I think, can I do it? No, I'm getting that. Let's go down here and take a look. The top pillar, you don't want to dye the whole thing. Instead, you want it to dye just region 5. And so you want to do that for all the exposed pillars so that they kind of blend in a little more. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, we've got the interiors painted cantaloupe and the exteriors are painted cantaloupe as well. Your next step, and I've gone ahead and done this because I'm re-recording this section because I painted something the wrong color. you want to go ahead and paint the tops of these pillars cantaloupe as well. And the way you do that is you just select region 5. And if we just go ahead and do that, you can kind of see that it is region 5 that we want to paint. Okay, so if we select region 5, you hit die, you've got yourself a pillar that's cantaloupe, basically, for all intents and purposes. Okay, so next bit that we want to do, let's go ahead and continue kind of this cantaloupe coloring flavor thing, and let's work on this greenhouse glass. Okay, so the greenhouse glass, we don't want to paint cantaloupe, actually. We want to paint this a tangerine color. And the tangerine just kind of gives it a nice little darker kind of look to it. Almost kind of the look of burnt copper. And you want to do that for region 2 for everything except for the greenhouse doors. The greenhouse doors, you're actually going to want to paint tangerine so that it just has a little light touch to it. So let's go ahead and do all that, okay? Okay, so I've gone ahead and painted all these here, these four. These doors here, right here, these are actually cantaloupe. So we're going to make those cantaloupe. Everything else is the darker tangerine color. And I'm going to leave these. These are actually going to be cantaloupe as well. So the cantaloupe is the brighter color. It's going to be tangerine. I get these orange colors so mixed up. I apologize if I have screwed them up earlier in talking about them. But since these are not really kind of decorative pieces, I want them to be normal. And besides, I just don't like how it looks as a regular usable door. So there we go. Okay, so now that we've got that done, let's go ahead and work on everything else here, okay? Let's go ahead and work on the exterior. So the exterior is going to be this tan color. So let's go outside and let's just kind of see what it does in sunlight, okay? So we've got this kind of wall here, this kind of whitewashed wall. I don't want it to be so stone-like. I want to make a little bit of a subtle difference here. So here's the subtle difference. See if you can spot it, because it is pretty subtle. Let's go to region 1. Let's dye it. And all we need to do is region 1 for everything. It gives it a slight orange tint, but not as much as the cantaloupe up there. And that's exactly what we want. So we're just going to paint as region 1. Let's lag kicks in. There we go. And we're going to do that for everything, including the pillars here. Just fill it in. The pillars, you're going to need to do all 6 directions except for the top ones. You want to leave out region 5 when you paint the pillars. Okay? So let me go do that. You want to do this for the interior and the exterior. Do not paint the foundations. The foundations we will paint after this. Couple little things we get to do on the detail side of things. So for these ceilings, we of course want them to be the tan color, but let's take a look. Let's see which region we need to dye them. We need to dye them actually all 1 and 5, it looks like. So let's go ahead and do that, and let's enable that. And then we've got something with the stone foundations down below that we need to do before we stop with tan as well. So the exterior foundations, you can see that they don't look very good because they're still a different color from the rest of the house, right? So if we go ahead, we get close to one, and let's look at the side here. The side is region 2. We want to dye the region 2 and region 2 only, the tan color, okay? So let's go ahead and let's get all of that. And while you're at it, don't forget to fill in these doors. I forgot to do that. Don't forget to fill in this side as well. And then for these door frames, there's 2 of them. We need to paint all 3 regions on these door frames. If we don't, then we will kind of end up with this kind of look here where you have some of the stone that looks almost bluish, okay? Not last and least, we've got to go ahead, color these windows in, and then we can start working on the interior foundation as well as the railings, because we've got to get those too. But let's do the interior foundations first. So we've got a new color for these. Let's go and let's take slate and let's do region 1 only, and then just spray all of this all the way around. Even the outside. And when you are doing the interior ones, you can go ahead and do a little cheaty bit here. And you can do region 2 as well. So this bit right here, just be careful where you're painting. Be sure to check your exterior if you are not sure. I would certainly do that if I were you. Let's go ahead and paint these. And then we need to go outside. Grab that. And that. Okay, very nice. So that's just sort of the color of stone that we want to use for our foundation. I think it looks pretty darn good. This one looks a little odd, so because of the stair. So if you want to color this one slate, feel free. These two, it's fine if you do those. Just not the foundation of the house, because that'll break up this wall here. And we want the wall to look a little more uniform than that, right? Okay, so now with these things, kind of an interesting look here. I think what you want to do for the top here is paint it tan, as well as, let's see, region 2? Is that region 2 or is it region 3? So I think it's 1 and 3. Oh, I'm sorry. It's 1 and 2 that you want to paint tan, I think. So let's do that. Do that for all of them, and as well as these outside ones. I know you might have to do a little bit of scaffolding to get out here. Yeah, let's see. Nope, I would definitely, I'm getting scared. I would definitely build scaffolding for that if you want to paint those. But the important point is getting all of these white, and then if you think the stone sticks out too much, you can paint those slate as well. And next we need to paint the doors, and you want to enable regions 1, 5, and 6 with cantaloupe paint. And just do that. That looks pretty good. If you want, you can paint the metal a tan color, which I believe is region 4? It's region 4. So you can do region 4 for that. And the lock is region 2. So 4 and 2 makes a tan sort of look. Although on metal, You know, it's hit or miss. Do with it what you want. And don't forget this door as well. And last but not least is the fireplace. I accidentally painted it a little earlier when painting the walls. Just turn on all 6 regions, give it a go, and there you go. You got a nice little fireplace. Looks very nice on the inside and the outside too. Okay, it is time. Let's go ahead and let's look at the interior. Let's look at the furnishings. Normally, I don't walk you through how to place these because there usually is not much of a need to really, you know, show you how things are placed here. There's not a lot to it. You just put them down in a specific place and there you go. The colors on the kitchen area appliances, which is basically these two storage containers. This is parchment. It's very nice in with the chemistry table color. So, you know, lucky there. And then the yellow wood, this is olive. It's got kind of a birch quality to it. And so that's what I went with for all the wood elsewhere. I really wish ARK would fix these shelves because it doesn't look great when only part of it's painted. So you may want to leave those unpainted. I know we have some things that are unpainted because they just don't take the color. But as you can see here, we've got a nice fireplace. That's the family pet. A nice little storage box for wood. And we've got a bedroom here. As you can see, it looks very cozy, very nice in here. I didn't fill this in. Oops, server lag. I didn't fill this in. So we'll just close that. But as you can see, the interior is looking pretty good. Man, I really do want to see what you guys have. So, you know, please let me know in the comments section. Link me to pictures or videos or whatever. That might actually work better on Twitter. But, you know, just let me know if you have any building tips to improve this tutorial as well. Comment down below so that others watching can learn as well. And don't forget to subscribe. If you want more building tutorials, check out the video in the upper right-hand corner. Ooh, that's not the shot I wanted to give you. If you enjoyed it, please hit the like button. We'll see you next week for another building tutorial. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you later. Auf Wiedersehen. Arrivederci. Hasta la vista. Bye-bye.